Welcome back, y'all, to Sister Circle Live. Now, you've seen him here plenty of times, but our favorite movie critic is back to give a heads up on what's hitting theaters. Please welcome back down to the circle, Xilla Valentine.
Yay! Hey, what's up?
What's going on, Xilla?
I'm happy to be here. I cannot wait.
You look amazing.
Thank you very much.
You're slimming on down.
Yeah, I've been in the gym. Lost 40 pounds.
Give me five. Oh. Have this wealth. You better turn up on these people. You have been turning up out here, running around, doing these interviews for these movies.
Yeah.
And I have just been waiting till you come back so I can ask you all the questions.
Okay, let's talk.
So let's just get right on into it. Let's talk 21 Bridges.
Oh, my God.
I'm excited about this because we see Chadwick Boseman. I mean, we've seen him in plenty of lights before Black Panther, but it was like Black Panther, and that's like all we know of him.
Yeah, yeah.
So talk to us about what's going on in this movie.
This is an opportunity to see Chadwick Boseman really do his thing. We see him as other people.
Yeah.
We see him as the Black Panther, but in this movie, he's playing a character, Detective Andre Davis, whose father was killed, and he sort of goes into the business of being a cop. He's a good cop, and he's trying to figure out what happened in this murder mystery. Mm-hmm. It's a gritty film that we don't necessarily see anymore, but he does his thing, and it's very Denzel-esque.
Ah.
It's one of those roles that Denzel would play, and he's stellar. He puts on a masterclass when it comes to acting, and he's playing aside Stephon James, who was Jesse Owens, and he was John Lewis in Selma. Great actor from Toronto, and these two together is just absolutely phenomenal. They put on a clinic when it comes to acting with their roles. It's great.
When you say gritty, do you mean like Seven, like the movie Seven type of gritty, like the color and texture?
The color, it's definitely the color of it, but it's a New York drama and it's dark and you feel like you're in the streets of New York, which is really, really good. And it's like, it's really like, it's not overproduced, you know? So you feel like you're really on the streets. It's really great.
Now, you did some interviews with this cast. How was that?
It was really good. I tried to get some Black Panther information out of out of Chadwick, but he wouldn't budge.
He wouldn't tell.
But it was great because he threw a little shot at Scorsese. He was like, this movie has every element that makes cinema. Because, you know, he said that the Marvel movies aren't cinema. So Chadwick was like, it has all the elements that Scorsese said. It has something you at risk. It's a surprise element to it. And it really, really is cinema. Great film.
Okay, I'm going to go see it tonight.
You should.
Because it is out.
It is out tonight.
What about A Beautiful in the Neighborhood, which is a good time, a beautiful place in the neighborhood. What is he
A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood.
A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. Yeah. It's Tom Hanks.
Tom Hanks
is playing Mr. Rogers.
Yeah, Tom Hanks is phenomenal as Mr. Rogers. He's a supporting role in this movie too, which is you should keep in mind. It's really about Matthew Rhys and Susan Kelechi Watson and their couple. Then he goes to interview Mr. Rogers, but it's like one giant episode of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. And if you grew up with him, you might shed a tear because I shed a couple tears watching this as well.
I did grow up with Mr.
Rogers. When Tom Hanks comes in, he sings and he does a little flip. It's just, oh, God, that's Mr. Rogers.
Oh, my God. Well, I love Tom Hanks, so I can't wait to see it. Because he never does wrong in any movie.
Never
like,
does
I'm still
wrong.
On Castaway.
Yes.
But let's get into Queen and Slim.
Yes, indeed.
Because we've talked about Queen and Slim 1,000 times
yes,
on here
we
because we've been just waiting and waiting and waiting. So now it's here. Have you seen it?
Yes, I have seen Queen and Slim.
Oh, my God.
It is a stellar love story.
Ugh.
It really highlights how complicated Black love is. Because if you're in love, you don't just like, oh, I love you and we're together forever. You go through some stuff.
Right.
And this couple was on a first date. It goes kind of bad. End up getting pulled over by the cops. He kills the cops and they go on a run. And you sort of see their relationship go there. Mm-hmm. Like imagine going on a run with somebody you just had a bad date with.
Right.
And visually it's stunning. What Melina did with this film is just great.
God.
It looks like a giant music video.
It does. You can tell that from the trailers. Now you sat down with them as well.
Yes, indeed.
What did they say? Well, how did they feel about being in such a story that is so current and synonymous to what we're dealing with in America now?
Well, here it is. When I sat down with Lena Waithe, she said, asked her when was the last time someone was blinded by her blackness. And she said, every day. And she goes on to say that she stopped code switching. And being that she stopped code switching, she sort of, it sort of opened her world up to a bunch more. And she says that our culture is just as worthy as theirs. And I made this film for us. And if white people want to come along and sit in and watch it, they can. But this is a movie for us. And we don't have to bend to their culture. So it's a movie for us, it's our movie. And you know, if white people want to watch it, they can.
I mean, when they watched Black Panther.
They did watch Black Panther.
And speaking of us, Jay-Z is creating a movie, well, he's a series on Netflix with Idris Elba.
Idris Elba and Jonathan Majors. It's a black Western. It's called the harder they fall. And it's about a guy named Nat who parents get murdered by Idris. Uh-huh. And then when Idris gets out of jail, Jonathan Majors gets his gang back together and he goes to try to kill Idris.
Wow.
So when Idris plays the bad guy, I just think it's super great. Mm-hmm. I cannot wait to see Idris and Jonathan Majors. He was in a movie called Hostiles. He was also in White Boy Rick. He plays the main villain. He plays the main drug dealer in White Boy Rick. He's really, really
good.
He's really good.
Yeah,
no one knows him though. And he's also in an HBO show with Journey Smollett.
Okay. Yeah. So last but not least, really quickly, I have to know about The Irishman. Is Robert De Niro back with Al Pacino and Joe Pesci?
Yeah.
Come on, man.
The Irishman is phenomenal. It is a really, not to jump back on this,
it's
but
casino.
Cinema at its best. It's 3.5 hours long, though. So if you watch it on Netflix, watch it, chop it up. But it's a great film. Mm-hmm. Seeing Pesci play the mob boss is mm-hmm. great. Pacino as Jimmy Hoffa mm-hmm. is great as well. And then De Niro, you can't do no wrong with De Niro. Just great.
I mean, I can't wait to see it. Well, Xilla, thank you so much for hanging with us today. Keep up on all of his hilarious interviews and more. Check out his Instagram @blogzilla. Coming up.